Hello and welcome to Maths by SAS. This is my third lesson of D3, chapter number 6, exercise 6D, that is about parallel and perpendicular lines. What are the parallel lines and perpendicular lines, and what are the conditions for two lines to be parallel and perpendicular? These are the questions that have to be really clear to all of my students before moving to the next class. If you are not clear about these questions, or you have missed the previous lesson, or those who are catching us late, for all these students, I will be giving the link of the lesson in the description box because you have to watch and understand that lesson properly for better understanding of this lesson, because lessons of mathematics are integrated with each other. If one link is weak, the next lesson will also be affected. In this lesson, I will be discussing intermediate level question number 5. And question 5 says that to find the equation of line passing through the point minus 2 and 5 and parallel to the line 3y plus 7x equals to 29. And in the second part, the line is passing through the point minus 1 minus 6 and perpendicular to 42x minus 7y equals to 5. And in the third part, 4, 8 and it's parallel to 3x plus 7y equals to 17. And in the last part, the line is passing through point 2 and minus 3 and it's perpendicular to the line y plus 2x equals to 13. Really important question. Recall that under what condition and how to find the equation of the line, non-vertical line y equals to mx plus c, when we are given with a point and when we have to find the gradient of the line from the given line. Okay, because in the first part, in A part, the line has to pass through minus 2 and 5, and we have to find the line which is passing through this point and is parallel to this line. So because the new line is parallel to, because new line is, or required line is parallel to, line is parallel to 3y plus 7x equals to 29. As we have to find the equation of line in y equals to mx plus c form, c has to be calculated with the help of the point, but where to get the gradient, that is important. New line is parallel to this line, so first of all, we are going to find the gradient of this given line. And gradient of this given line is that we have to express this line in form of y equals to mx plus c. So for that purpose, what we are going to do is that 3y equals to minus 7x plus 29. 29 was already there. Now I have to make the coefficient of y 1. I have to make y free from the number. So divide this 3 to other side and equation will take the form minus 7x plus 29 by 3. Or what we can do is that minus 7 by 3x plus 29 by 3. Okay, now I have expressed this line in form of y equals to mx plus c. Now the coefficient of x will be the gradient of this line, and that will be the gradient of new line as well. That will be the gradient of new line as well. Why that will be the gradient of new line as well? Because the given line is, required line is parallel to given line. So what we have to do is, we have m with us, that y equals to minus 7 by 3x, 7 by 3 and x and c. In order to find c, I will be taking help from the point minus 2 and 5, because line is parallel to this given line but passes through this point. Here the y value is 5 and this is equal to minus 7 by 3 into minus 2 plus c. Now this minus can become positive and 5 equals to 14 by 3 plus c. Now what I can do is, I can shift this 14 by 3 to other side. 5 minus 14 by 3 equals to C. Okay, let me move towards this side. Okay, then here I have to take the LCM, and LCM is 3. This will become 15 minus 14 equals to C, and this is 1 by 3 equals to C. Now I have M with me, I have C with me, so the required equation which is parallel to this line will be y equals to minus 7 by 3 x plus 1 by 3. Or what we can do is that here 3 is the LCM, so minus 7x plus 1 and y, or 3y equals to minus 7x plus 1. This is the equation of required line which is parallel to this given line. Moving to the second part, in the B part, the given point is minus 1 and minus 6, and the line is perpendicular to, we have to find a new line which is perpendicular to 42x minus 7y equals to 5. Okay, as we have to find the equation of line which is perpendicular to this line but in the form y equals to mx plus c, it's important to identify m. So first of all, we are going to transform this equation in y equals to mx plus c form. So the equation will take the form 42x minus 7y equals to 5, or minus 7y equals to minus 42x and plus 5. Now what I have to do is I have to shift this minus 7 to other side, and equation will take the form minus 42x plus 5 by minus 7. Okay, now I have to write the denominator 7 of both the terms. It will take the form minus 42 by minus 7x minus 5 by 7 y, and minus sign will be going, minus sign will be going, and 7 ones are and 7 six are, so y equals to 6x and minus 5 by 7. Now I have expressed my given equation in form of y equals to mx plus c. Here the coefficient of x is 6, so the gradient of this line, m of this line will be 6. This is the gradient of this line, but we have to find a line which is perpendicular to this line. So the gradient of required lines, let m dash be the gradient of line perpendicular to this line, line perpendicular to given line, given line. Therefore what will happen, m multiplied by m dash equals to minus 1. This is a condition for two lines to be perpendicular. 6 m dash equals to minus 1, or m dash equals to minus 1 by 6. This is the gradient of the line which is perpendicular to the given line. Okay, now I have gradient with me, and now I have to go for the calculation of y equals to mx plus c. So y equals to minus 1 by 6x plus c, and in order to find value of c, I have to take help from the point minus 1 and minus 6. Okay, it means that y value is minus 6 equals to minus 1 by 6 into minus 1 plus c. This minus sign will be becoming positive, because minus multiplied by minus is positive. Minus 6 equals to 1 by 6 plus c. And now what I have to do, I have to take the LCM here, and this will take the form 6 equals to minus 6 equals to 1 plus 6c. Go for cross multiplication. I have the space, I can accommodate my working here. Minus 36 equals to 1 plus 6c, or shift this one to other side, minus 1 equals to 6c or c equals to minus 37 by 6 equals to c. Now I have the value of gradient with me, I have the value of c with me, so the required equation of line. So required equation of line will be y equals to minus 1 by 6x minus 37 by 6, which is the value of c. Now take the LCM, that this is 6 and minus x minus 37, go for cross multiplication, 6y equals to minus x and minus 37. Either you can leave your working at this stage, or what we can do is that shift x to other side, and it will take the form 6y plus x equals to 37. I hope you are clear about these two parts. And for the next part, let me take one more page here, okay? And this is the continuation lesson. Let me keep something over here. And over here, I have to solve. This is exercise 6D. And lesson number is 3. And we are discussing question number 5. And here, I will solve C part of this question. And in C part, the point through which the line is passing is 4 and 8. And that line is parallel to the line 3x plus y equals to 17. Okay, as we know that we have to find the equation of line, non-vertical line, in y equals to mx plus c form. In order to find value of c, we have to take the help from the given point, but from where we have to find the gradient, for that we have to take the help from the given line, because the new line is parallel to this line. Okay, so what we have to do is that 3x plus y equals to 17 and y equals to minus 3x plus 17, and here I am identifying the coefficient of x, which is m. Gradient of this line is m equals to minus 3, because the required line is parallel to given line. Therefore, what will happen that if m dash is the gradient of that line, m will be equal to m prime will be equal to minus 3. Now we have the gradient with us, and now what we have to do is we have to go for the equation of line, which is parallel to this line, y equals to minus 3x plus c. And for the calculation of c, we'll be taking the help from the given point, which is 4 and 8. That means that instead of x, you have to replace 4 plus c, and this is 8. This is 8 equals to minus 12 plus c. Move to this side, 8 plus 12, okay, equals to c, and 8 plus 12 is 20 equals to c. Now we have the value of gradient with us, and we have the value of c with us, okay, and now we can write down the equation of line. So equation of line is y equals to minus 3x plus 20. This is the equation of line, which is parallel to given line. I hope you are clear about this part, and let's quickly move to the last part of this question. And let me separate this place so that my students should not mix the working with the other part. Okay, now what we have to do is, let me read last part of the question. And the last part says, we have to find the equation of line which is passing through 2 and minus 3. 2 and minus 3, and it is perpendicular to the line y plus 2x equals to 30. Okay, as we have to find the equation of line which passes through this point but is perpendicular to this line, recall the condition for two lines to be perpendicular that the product of their gradients m1 multiplied by m2 equals to minus 1. So it means that first of all I have to find the gradient of this line, and then I have to apply this condition to find the gradient of the line which is perpendicular to this line. So let's move to the solution of this part. Okay, so what we have to do is that we have to express this equation in standard form of non-vertical line. That shift this 2x to other side, it will take the form y equals to minus 2x plus 13. Now the equation is expressed in standard y equals to mx plus c form, and this is the gradient of this line. Gradient of this line, let it be m1. The gradient of this line is minus 2. Okay, now the gradient of line perpendicular to given line is m2. So m1 multiplied by m2 equals to minus 1. This is the condition that we are going to apply. Minus 2 into m2 equals to minus 1. M2 equals to minus sign can go. Algebra and integers have to be really strong. M2 is 1 by 2. This is a gradient of line which is perpendicular to the given line. Now we have to find the equation of line. Now we have a gradient with us. And we have the point with us. Okay. So what we have to do is that y equals to mx plus c. And instead of m, I have to replace 1 by 2x and plus c. And for the calculation of c, we can take the help from 2 and minus 3. Because this is a point given through which this line is passing. Y value is minus 3 and x value is 2 plus c. Now look, this 2 ones are and 2 ones are. Minus 3 equals to 1. Plus c, shift 1 to other side, minus 3 minus 1 equals to c, minus 4 equals to c. Now we have value of m with us, value of c with us. So what we can do is required equation of line is y equals to 1 by 2x minus 4. Okay, either you can leave your working at this stage or make your equation free from fraction by taking the LCM. Okay, and this is x minus 8 equals to y, or 2y equals to x minus 8. I hope you are clear about this question. For next difficulty level, please watch and understand this lesson. Please watch my lessons, like, share and subscribe the channel, and press bell icon to get the notification of every lesson in time. Thank you very much.